Hello friends. So in the previous video, we have actually derived the final equivalent circuit of a single phase induction motor running with a single winding. You have to remember that the equivalent circuit that we have derived is for a single phase induction motor with a single winding. Okay, so we'll just go through the sequence of events because today we are going to cover a very important topic. Okay, so you started with your analysis like this. You are having a single phase induction motor and it is a single winding. Voltage applied is Vm and Im. Okay, then I told you this condition is very similar of having another winding which we called the winding A and assuming that current to be equal to zero. These two situations are identical. By doing an analysis, understanding something like this, we could divide these two unbalanced supplies. It is like an unbalanced two-phase supply into two balanced supplies, right? So one is called positive sequence, one is called negative sequence. So this Ia1 and Im1 form the positive sequence and this is the phasor diagram for that. This is Ia1 and this is Im1, right? Ia1 was the leading and Im1 was the lagging case, lead, lag. Similarly, in this case, Ia2 was the lagging case and Im2 was the leading case. So the magnetic field always moves from the leading side to the lagging side, right? We told you that somebody is giving an external rotation in the clockwise direction and based on all these things, we found out there are two torques which are going to get involved. One is called the forward torque, first the positive sequence, which is in the direction of the rotation of the rotor. The other one was called the reverse torque or backward torque, which is in the opposite direction of the rotation. So the net torque will be equal to forward torque minus the reverse torque. And again, we did some mathematical jugglery and finally, we got this particular equivalent circuit. So this is the equivalent circuit for a single phase induction motor with one winding, with a single winding, with a single winding. So today we are going to actually start the torque slip characteristic of this single phase induction motor with one winding. Okay. So to draw the torque slip characteristics, we'll just draw the axis first. So this is not good axis. Let me just draw it once again. Yeah, I'll just try to draw it a little bit more straight. Yeah, so this is the torque. Okay, we'll just take it as torque and this is the slip. So this is slip is equal to 0, right? And somewhere around here you will have slip is equal to 1 and somewhere around here let us take the slip will be equal to 2. Okay, why we are taking that slip is equal to 2 will come as the explanation proceeds. So this is the slip axis, right? So this is the slip axis and this is the thing. Now, you know that the induction motor has two components, right? The induction motor which we considered, that is this single phase induction motor, has two components. One is the positive sequence and one is the negative sequence. Two motors, positive sequence motor, negative sequence motor. Now, these two are two-phase balanced motor. This is a two-phase balanced motor and this is also a two-phase balanced motor, right? So we'll take the forward case now. Now because this is a two-phase balanced motor, the torque slip characteristic of this particular motor here will be no different from that of a three-phase induction motor. See, in three-phase induction motor, how we are deriving the torque slip equations, torque and slip relations, you are finding the equivalent circuit, that is the per phase analysis, and from that you are finding the torque slip characteristics. So this is a two-phase induction motor, right? So for the two-phase induction motor and the three-phase induction motor, the maximum torque that and all might change, but otherwise the shape of the induction motor will be not different. There is no reason for that to be different because this is the only difference is the number of phases. So if you do a per phase analysis, everything will look same. Okay, so you know that three phase induction motor, how the torque slip characteristics looks like, it looks something like this, right? So that is what we are going to do here. So we'll draw the torque slip characteristic. So this is the torque slip, maximum torque, and it comes around something like this, right? It goes like this. So this slip is equal to 0 means n is equal to nr is equal to ns. When slip is equal to 1, you know that n is equal to nr is equal to 0. So this torque, we call it as the starting torque. This is the maximum torque and all those blah blah blah. But here we are not interested in that. Here we want to find what is the net torque of the single phase induction motor. See, this graph is for the forward motor, right? This is for the forward motor. So I'll write down it. So this is for the positive sequence or the forward motor. Forward motor in the sense the direction of the torque and the direction of rotation of the rotor is the same. Okay, both are in the clockwise direction. So this is one part. So now you know that for some value of slip. Okay. And another thing which I want you to remember here, that for the positive sequence, if the slip value, SF you call it, is S. Okay. For the negative sequence, you know that it's called the backward slip. That value is 2 minus S. That also we have found out. Okay. So, for example, for some slip of S1, for some slip of S1, what will be the forward torque? Okay. How you will find out? So, you will take some point here, which is S1. Right, this S is equal to S1. This is some point S equal to S1. So you put it here like this. Excuse me. And this particular torque will be the forward torque. So this value TEF1 will be the torque at slip S1. Right, TEF1 is the torque, forward torque of the positive sequence motor or the forward motor at slip S1. So how you will find for the negative sequence? Okay, so that is also very easy. See, negative, when the positive motor has slip S1, okay, the negative motor will have 2 minus S1, right? For the positive sequence, if it is S1, the negative sequence motor will have slip 2 minus S1. So that is why we are taking it here. So this value is S1, right? So 2 minus S1 will be somewhere around here, right? So this value will be 2 minus S1. So this is 2 minus S1. So here you are getting your, this value will be TEB1. Okay, if I project it here, this will be TEB1. So what is the net torque? The net torque, you know that, will be equal to, that is the net torque at slip S1, at slip S1 will be equal to TEF1 minus TEB1. It's actually tau, but it is more comfortable to call it as T. Okay, so TEB1. So this is the thing here. Okay, so for some other slip value, for example S2, okay, for some other slip value S is equal to S2. Okay, so this is the forward torque. Excuse me, I'm not feeling that well today. Little bit of cough and cold. So this is TEF2. Okay, so this is TEF2. So corresponding to this, you will have another slip. That is, this is for S1. Okay, so SF is equal to S1, sorry, S2. And then the backward slip will be 2 minus S2. Right, so this is TEF2, forward torque corresponding to slip S2. So this 2 minus S2 will be somewhere around here. Right, so this is your 2 minus S2. So corresponding to that, you are having another torque value. So this value is TEB2, right? So the net torque at slip S2 will be equal to TEF2 minus TEB2, okay? So this is how you do. So you can find for each and every point like this, and then you will get another characteristic. So if you join all these points together, you will get another characteristic, and that will be the torque slip characteristic of the single phase induction motor with single winding. But this is not a, it is a little bit difficult, but there is a more easier graphical method to do the same thing. So basically what you are doing, for example, let us take at slip S equal to 0 here. For example, we are taking at slip S equal to 0. So at slip S equal to 0, you can see that, see at slip S equal to 0, you see, at S equal to 0, the forward torque is equal to 0. TEF is equal to 0. And what is the backward torque? Backward torque, so corresponding to this, the backward slip will be equal to 2 minus 0 is equal to 2. This is this value here. So this value, right? We can call it as TEB0. It will be this value. So this is equal to TEB0. TEB0. That means the net torque will be equal to, at slip S equal to 0, TEF minus TEB, right? So this is 0 minus TEB0. That means net torque is equal to minus TEB0, right? So what you are doing is that you are taking the value, and so that value, for example, that value will be somewhere around here, right? So minus TEB0, this will be, for example, minus TEB0. This will be minus TEB0, okay? And for example, at S equal to 1, see at S equal to 1, at slip S equal to 1. Okay, so this is the forward torque. At slip S equal to 1, this is the forward torque, for example, right? TEF1. Okay, this is TEF1. Okay, and this is for the forward motor. For the backward motor, what will be the slip? For the SB will be equal to 2 minus 1, right? 2 minus S. So 2 minus S, 2 minus 1, and that slip also is equal to 1. That means this will be TEB1. Because both are same, both slips are S equal to 1. So this TEF1 will be equal to TEB1, right? So in this case, what will be the net torque? The net torque will be equal to TEF1 minus TEB1. Because these two values are equal, the net torque will be equal to 0. So you are starting at some point here, right? You're starting at some point here, and then that value is going to zero. A very simple method of doing the same graphically is that you take the mirror image of this, right? This graph, this is the forward motor graph, right? You take the mirror image and you just flip the graph. Okay, so you will get all these points here. You will get all these points here, and for some value of slip, if you want to find, you can easily find it like that. So basically, see what you are doing. You are taking this value and you are putting here. You are taking this value, you are putting here. You are taking this value and you are putting it here, right? So for example, in this case, what will be this value? This will be TeB1, right? This will be TeB. So this torque value minus this torque value will be the effective torque, and that value will be this value here, zero. Okay, so we'll draw it graphically and see how it is coming. Okay, so we'll just draw this once again so that we have a little bit more clarity here, right? So this is your slip axis, this is your torque axis, right? And we found outside this is the forward torque motor, right? So this is slip s equal to zero, for example. This is slip s equal to one, right? And say this is slip s equal to two. So what I told, you take the mirror image and flip the motor. That means take the mirror image and flip the graph. So you will get something like this. So you will start from this value here. Okay, you start from this. This is just to draw the reverse motor characteristics. Okay, so that is because TeF minus TeB, right? So that is why it is coming in the negative axis. Okay, so we will draw the graph here. Okay, so something like this you will get. So it will be starting like this, and these two values will be exactly the same, because at s equal to 1, you have already seen the net torque will be equal to 0. So it will be something like this. Okay, it's very difficult to draw all these things like this. Okay, so it will go and at this point it will come and meet here. Okay, this point it will come and meet here. You can just try it out. Okay, so now let us find for the different values. For example, at s equal to 0, so this is forward motor and this is negative reverse motor. This is for TeF. This graph is for TeF and this is for TeB, and we have put it in the negative axis. Okay, so you can subtract it easily. This is just a graphical way of putting all these things. You can do by this method also, but this is a better method. Graphically you can see. So at slip s equal to 0, what is the slip value? At slip s equal to 0, this forward torque is equal to 0. And this is the value of the reverse torque, right? This is the value of the reverse torque. So, 0 minus this value, 0 minus this value. So, your graph is going to start from this point here. This graph is going to start from this point, okay? So, what is that graph? That is the net torque graph, okay? This is the forward motor, this is the reverse motor, and this will be the net torque graph, okay? So, this is just a graphical way of putting it, okay? Remember that. This is just a graphical way of putting it. So, we will draw that curve in the green color. And see, from here if you start, you see that the forward torque is increasing, right? We are drawing the torque versus slip characteristics, variation of torque with respect to increase in slip. So you can see from here, you can see the torque, forward torque value is higher than the reverse torque value. So naturally the net torque value, which is forward torque minus backward torque, will increase, right? This increases more than this increase. So naturally this value will start from where, somewhere here, and it will increase. And it will reach a peak where this also reaches a peak. Afterwards, you see the increase in forward torque is decreasing, right? The forward torque is actually decreasing. It is increasing till this point, and from here the forward torque is decreasing. But you can see that the reverse torque, you can see that graph is continuously increasing. So naturally the net torque, now forward torque is not increasing, it is decreasing, and the reverse torque is increasing. So we'll just write it like that, right? So from this point to this point here, you can call it from point A to point B. So from A to B, torque forward increases, right, minus torque B, that increase is not much, right, that increase is not, it is also increasing, but it is not much. This increase is much higher than this backward torque increase. So here that implies the net torque will increase, net torque will increase. From point B to some other point, you can see that the forward torque value is decreasing, but the backward torque value is increasing. Backward torque value is increasing, right? Backward torque value, that means the net torque will decrease, because net torque is forward torque minus backward torque. So if backward torque is increasing, net torque will decrease. So here net torque will decrease, right? And at slip s equal to 1, at slip s equal to 1, this is the forward torque. At slip s equal to 1, this is the forward torque. And at slip s equal to 1, this is the reverse torque. And these two values are exactly equal to 0, right? So, from B to C. So at point C, we'll call this point as C. At point C, that is slip s equal to 1, the forward torque is equal to the backward torque. Forward torque is equal to the backward torque. That means the net torque value will be equal to 0. The net torque value will be equal to 0. Something like this, okay? Just draw it properly. So, it will come like this. Net torque value is equal to 0. So, from here also, the same case only will come. It will come like this. From here, it is going to increase like this. And it, in the reverse direction, the torque is going to come to a maximum value. From the reverse direction, the torque is going to come to a maximum value. At slip s equal to 2, if you see, we'll just take that point. At slip s equal to 2, see, the reverse torque value is 0. So, at slip s equal to 2, this is the reverse torque, right? Backward torque. Backward torque is equal to 0. Backward torque is equal to 0. But the forward torque has some value. Right? This is the forward torque. Forward torque is, this is backward torque and this is forward torque. That means the torque net is equal to Tf minus 0, which is some value Tf. Okay? It is some value of torque. So, it is a positive value also. So, the graph will come here and it will come like this. Right? It is something like this here. Okay? So, this green color line, this green color line is the actual torque versus slip characteristic of a single phase induction motor with one winding, with a single winding. Not one winding, the actual term is a single winding, right? So, this green line here you see, it is the torque slip characteristics of a single phase induction motor with a single winding. And this top graph, forward torque, this is the reverse torque. This is the graphical way of putting it. Other than that, the analytical way also you will find the same value. If you do this thing, whatever I have told you here, do this procedure, there also you will get the same curve, something like this. If you do and plot all the points, here also you will get a similar curve like this, something like this. Get a curve something like this. So, if you do like this, so you have to find each and every point. Other than that, if you graphically also you can do. So, that is what we have seen here. Okay. So, this is the basic idea. You can see that at s equal to 1, you know that nr is equal to 0. Right. At s equal to 1, nr is equal to 0. The net torque is equal to 0. But in any other case, you can see the torque is not equal to 0. That is what I told. The starting torque of the single phase induction motor with a single phase wind, with a single winding is 0. But the running torque is not equal to 0. See, running torque is, so all other conditions, you are having a valid net torque. Okay. See, but this is not a good technique. See, what we did, we did an external rotation and then we did all these mathematical analysis. And finally, we got this torque slip characteristics, which is very interesting. But this is not the correct way. Trying to rotate it externally, this is not the correct way. You are having a motor. If you give single phase supply to that, it should rotate. Then only it is called a single phase induction motor, right? So, all these things is okay. But then we have to understand how we can start the single phase induction motor with just one supply. Okay, so that is very important concept. From the next video onwards, we will be looking through many methods of how we can achieve that. So, I hope today's lecture is very clear. If you are having any doubts, please put them in the comments below. If I am not able to respond very fast, but I will surely respond if the I am able to understand your question properly. Other than that, one request what I have is to the viewers is that whenever you are seeing a video, in case you have understood the video fully, just go through the comments section once. Because there are hardly 5 or 6 comments which come. It is not a very big deal. Okay. Before that, I will just save this document. Yeah. It is not a very big deal. So, if you are able to clear that doubt, because I might not always find the time to do go through all the things. Because, for example, if somebody is asking a doubt from DC machines, which was a topic which was 2 years ago, I might not remember all the concepts. Very minute details I might not able to remember. I remember all the basic ideas and all those things, but some minute details I might not remember. If a very specific doubt is asked, I have to go and watch that video once again and just to understand, just to refresh myself. Okay, I also forget all these things. Unless I refresh all these things, I also forget. So, if you are going through some DC machines topic and you have understood and you are finding a doubt where you can answer that doubt, okay, that will be very helpful for me. And that is how a community grows, right? A community grows when the community helps each other. A single person cannot grow a community. So my vision of this channel is to create a strong community of electrical engineers. So if you are having the answers to the doubts which are asked, don't shy away from that. Do help the others also. You can just write down that comment and of what doubt that person might be having. If you are able to clear it, is well and good. Okay. I also will try from my side, but if you viewers, you also help me, it will help the channel a lot. Okay. So with that, let us conclude today's video. So till I see you in the next video, it's me, Varun, signing off, and have a great day. Thank you. Now that the video is over, please stay with me for 30 more seconds. Now the vision of this channel is to create a repository of good quality videos with crystal clear explanation regarding various topics related to electrical engineering. Now if you want to help me spread the word, please share this video with anyone interested in these topics. The second thing is that for me, education is a two-way process. Therefore, if you have any doubts or suggestions regarding any of the videos or regarding the channel, please put them in the comments below. We can have a healthy discussion, and that way we can build a strong community of electrical engineers. So that's it for today's video. So till I see you in the next time, it's me, Varun, signing off, and have a great day. Thank you.